introduction to Dockerfile?
So a Dockerfile is nothing but a text document in which you write how do you want your container to be customized. So one example, like I just told you guys, was when I did it manually. I ran a container, I went inside it, I installed the software, came out, committed the container, and then pushed it onto Docker Hub. Now, all these changes can be automated using a script style, which we call the Dockerfile. Now, a Dockerfile is very easy to write, and there are basically some nomenclatures or there's some syntaxes that you would have to learn, but I'm sure they are very easy to learn, and once you learn them, it'll only be Dockerfile that you would be using rather than doing everything manually. Right, so let's go ahead and see how we can create a Dockerfile. So guys, these are some of the syntaxes, these are some of the important syntaxes that are relevant to creating a Dockerfile. Now, the first line of a Dockerfile is always from, right? So the image on which you want to make changes, for example, we made changes on the Ubuntu images where we installed Apache. Right, so what we did docker run -it-d and then Ubuntu. So in Dockerfile, the first base image that you want to work on, you'll have to specify it on the first line using the command from. Okay, so this area of your presentation will basically tell you the Dockerfile content. So this is exactly how the content of the Dockerfile should look like. So the first command is from. So from Ubuntu. So the base image that I want to work on is Ubuntu. So this would be the first line. Second command would be to add all the files. So add is basically used to add files inside a container. Now, for example, say I create a HTML file and I want that HTML file to be added inside the Ubuntu container. So for doing that, the command add, the first argument would be the place where the files are present, and the second argument would basically be the location inside the container where you want all those files to be copied. All right, so add space dot, the meaning take files or take all the files from the current directory and put it inside /var/www/html. All right, so this is what the add command does. The third is run. So whenever you want to run any command in the container, for example, I ran apt-get update and apt-get install apache2 inside the container, right? Now, if you want to run the same commands from the Dockerfile, you can do that using the command run. So over here, there are two commands that I want to run. The first is apt-get update and the second is apt-get install apache2, right? The hyphen y signifies over here the option that we get, that whether you want to go ahead with the installation, yes or no. So if you specify hyphen y implicitly in Dockerfile, it would not ask that option. It would continue the installation without any prompts. Alright, so run command is basically used to run any command inside the container on the terminal that you would have ran. Okay, then you have a command called cmd. So cmd keyword is basically used to run all any command that you want to run at the start of the container. Alright, and these commands run only when there is no argument specified while you're running the container. So while you're running a container, you can also specify any command that you want to run. So in case you specify a command while so for running a container, the command is docker run -it-d and then the image name. Now after the image name, you can also specify a command that you want to run inside the container. Okay, so if you don't specify anything like we did, then in the Dockerfile, this command will be running when we are starting the container. Otherwise, whatever command we specify in the docker run command, that would be running. Okay, then so this was about the cmd command line. So in this case, what we are doing is, what we want to do is, like, remember when we started the container, we always had to go inside the container and start the Apache service manually. That is, once the image is started or once the container is started, go inside the container and type in the command service Apache to start, right? So that had to be done manually. But when you pass it using the command cmd, which is nothing but all the commands run on the startup time. Whenever the container will start, this command will execute automatically if you specify it under cmd. So cmd apache ctl hyphen d foreground would do nothing but run Apache the moment the container starts. And this is exactly what we want, right? So this is possible using cmd. So again, I'll repeat it. Cmd is used to run commands at the runtime of a container, and they run only when there is no argument specified in the Docker run command. If there is no argument specified, the cmd command will run. Otherwise, it will be skipped from the Dockerfile. Alright, the next command is entry point. Now, entry point is exactly the same as cmd, it runs at the starting of the container, but the only difference is cmd will not run if you specify an argument in Docker run, but entry point will run irrespective of the fact whether you have specified an argument or not. Alright, so cmd and entry point can be used interchangeably, but if there are cases when you'll be running the container with an argument, so it's better to use entry point so that the command does not get skipped. Cmd command will get skipped if you specify an argument after the Docker run command. Okay, so in our case, we use the Apache ctl-d foreground with the entry point command. All right. The next command is env. So if there are any environment variables that you want to set inside a container, you can pass it using the command env space the name of the variable and space the value of the variable. Alright, so in my case, I specified a variable name which has the value DevOps Intellipaat. Alright, so these are some of the commands that you can use to create a Dockerfile. Now, let us create this Dockerfile on our system as well. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to my PuTTY software and I'm going to specify nano and then Dockerfile. So let me just create a directory first. So let me create a directory called Dockerfile itself. So mkdr Dockerfile. Let us go inside it. So cd Dockerfile. And now whenever you are creating a Dockerfile, the name of the file always has to be Dockerfile itself, right? So I'll specify nano and then Dockerfile. We went inside. So the first thing that we want to do is we want the Ubuntu image to be called. Then we want to update this image. So apt-get update. Then we want to install Apache inside it. apt-get hyphen y. Sorry about that. So apt-get hyphen y. Install Apache 2. Alright, sounds good. Then we are going to add all the files from this directory to the directory where www.html. So we're going to create this file. Do not worry, we'll just create this file. Right, once we have done that, the next step would be to run Apache in the foreground. That is, run it. So Apache ctl hyphen d foreground. So this would run Apache automatically. Okay, and you specify the entry point and say I also want to specify environment variable. Say let me create an environment variable called name, and I want to specify the value as Intellipaat. Okay, sounds good. So this is my Dockerfile, and I'll just save this now. And let me create a HTML file as well. So let's create one.html. And let us make it a little simple. So this would be a hello world HTML file. Okay, the body, and in the body say I have an h1 which will say hello from Intellipaat. Close the header, close the body, and then close the HTML. Alright, this is what I want to do. I'll save this, and now we are done with the Dockerfile and we have the HTML page in place. So the next step would be to build this Dockerfile. Now let's see how we can build it. So for building this Dockerfile, all you have to do is docker build. Where do you want to build it? I want to build it from the current directory, and the image that it will create, I want to name that image as, say, new_dockerfile. Okay, so it will be named like this. So I'll hit enter, and I forgot to mention sudo. So let me just clear the screen. All right, so let me first teach you guys how to run a docker command without sudo. So for doing that, just type in sudo user mod hyphen -ang, and then docker, and then $user. Enter. And now all I have to do is just re-login into your session, and this should work. So if I do a docker ps now without sudo, you can see the command is running. Awesome. So what I want to do is I want to go inside the Dockerfile. Okay. And now I want to build this Dockerfile. So docker build dot hyphen t new_Dockerfile. So you can see the Dockerfile is now being executed. And basically this is creating the container for me, and this will basically come up with an image which will have all the changes that we just told to the container. So now if I do a docker images, I can see that there is a new image which has been created, which is new_dockerfile. So let us run this new_dockerfile, docker run hyphen it hyphen d. Also, let us specify the port number. So let us open it at port 84, and then hyphen d new_dockerfile, and then hit enter. Okay, so the container is launched now. So if I do a docker ps, I can see that a container has been launched 7 seconds ago. Awesome. And it being opened on port 84. So let's check if everything is working well for us. So we just have to change this to 84, and you can see Apache is running. Awesome, Apache is running. And now let's check our web page if it's there in the container or not. So we named it as one.html, and yes, so this is the HTML that we created, which has been added inside the container. So let me show you inside the container what exactly happened. Okay, so docker exec hyphen it container name, and then bash, and let me just clear the screen. Okay, and let me compare it with my Dockerfile. So the first thing that we did was apt-get update apt-get hyphen y install apache 2. This basically installed Apache, so this was clear. Then we added everything from the current directory to where www.html. right? So if we go inside where and then www and then html and do an ls over there, you can see that the one.html file has been added, and at the same time Dockerfile was also added. So inside the doc, inside the directory, we had these two files, right? One.html and Dockerfile. So both of these were added inside the container. Now, to not have Dockerfile inside your container, what you can do is, instead of dot, specify ./ and one.html. That would solve this problem. It would only add one.html in the container. Okay, so it added one.html. And index.html is basically the default page of Apache that you see, right? So we added one.html. So this was added by the Dockerfile. At the same time, what we did again was we defined Apache to run in the foreground. So as you can see, we did not invoke the Apache service by going inside the container. We just went directly to the port number that we mapped the container to, and the Apache was up and running. So that is awesome. And the last thing that we did was we defined an environment variable. So what I can do is I can echo the variable, which is $name, and you can see this is the value of the variable that I specified in the Dockerfile. I specify the variable names to be Intellipaat, and if I specify echo $name, this is the value that I get automatically. So this was set by the Dockerfile in the container image that I just created. And now what I can do is I can just exit this container, and if I want you guys to use it, all I have to do is do a Docker push to this container on my Docker Hub, and you guys will also be able to access this particular container. Alright, so for that I'll just have to change the name, do a Docker push, and you should be able to use it. But I'm sure you would not be needing it, because if you pass the same commands that are written over here, you would get the exact same container that I created.